Measure 25. One and a two and ready. Measure 53. One, two, ready, play. Hello, and welcome to the tutorial section for Ruby by HA Vandercook. This is a fun trombone solo, and if all you play is the notes, then you'll sound fine. However, if you've made it to this point in the video, there's no question that you want to do more than just play a bunch of notes that you see on a page. You want to play what you see around the notes and try and make really nice music out of it. So we're going to go through a few of the sections here and show you just how to do that. The first section we'd like to look at is measures 5 through 8. You will notice that during these parts, there's a crescendo, which means get louder, and a decrescendo, which means gets softer. Now, the crescendo is one measure, and the decrescendo is one measure. This is what it sounds like when we don't do any dynamics there and just play the notes. Now listen to the difference when we add that one measure crescendo and that one measure decrescendo for this section of the piece. Now let's take a look at measures 9 through 12. The first thing we're going to do is play it without any dynamic contrast. We're just playing the notes. Now we're going to add the crescendo and the decrescendo. In one sense, this is making it more exciting because it's getting louder and softer, but it's also adding a little bit more drama because this time, instead of crescendoing and decrescendoing for one measure each, we're doing a two-measure crescendo followed by a two-measure decrescendo. Well, now you get the idea. Here's measures 13 and 14 played as written with the dynamics. And now we're going to do measures 15 through 20. This is two measures of crescendo from piano to forte, then one measure of just staying at forte, and then the rest of the phrase we're getting quieter, decrescendoing, all the way up to measure 20. Let's look at the moderato section of the piece, starting at measure 25. This is what those first few measures sound like when we don't do anything with dynamics. Even though it's not written, the measures with the dotted quarter followed by an eighth note, we're going to crescendo, and the loudest part of the crescendo is the downbeat of the next measure. This does add a little bit of excitement to the piece. Listen. Here's the coda, played as written. And when we come back, we're going to talk about how to make it even better. We're going to do two things with the coda to make it more interesting. The first one is those measures in the beginning of it that start with an eighth rest and two 16th notes accent the first 16th note. It may not make sense to you if you're playing by yourself, but if you ever perform this with a piano accompaniment, that first 16th note that you're playing is also when the piano is playing an accented note. So if you accent with the piano, it's going to sound great. The second part of this is the measures with just the alternating eighth notes. Instead of playing it all loud, start softly and crescendo all the way to the end of those moving eighth notes until the downbeat of just the single eighth note. There are two places in the piece where we're going to use an alternate position F. By that, I mean that normally when you see an F on the fourth line of the staff, you're going to play it in first position, but you can also play it in sixth. What I'd like to do is demonstrate the two spots. The first one is measures 13 through 16. Here is that phrase with the F in first position. Here it is again with the F in the beginning of measure 15 played in sixth position. What this will do is allow you to smoothly just bring your slide up to the fourth position G and then the third position G sharp, and then you'll be finishing on second position A. Here's measures 17 through 20. I will be playing that last note of the phrase, which is the F, in first position. I want you to see if you can hear the little bump that we hear between the note before the F and that F. Now we're going to play it again, but instead of going from fourth position G to the first position F, we're just going to keep the slide going down from fourth position G down to sixth position F. It is much smoother, there's no bump, and I think you're going to like it. There may be some of you who are having trouble reaching sixth position on your own. If that's the case, take your extendabone and go ahead and put it on your slide, and that will help you reach sixth position because your arm will get to fourth or fifth, and then with your wrist you can just move the slide out to sixth. Here is measures 13 through 20 with the extendabone in use. Well, thank you so much for spending a little bit of time with us today. I hope that you found this tutorial section of the video helpful, and I look forward to hearing you playing Ruby. Please do send us a video here to the Trombone Place. We'd love to see it. If you have any questions or any comments, don't hesitate to email me. My email address is thetromboneplace@gmail.com. Once again, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.